Well, yeah, I definitely have, like, yeah, my main channel is just there to be entertaining and to make fun stuff for people to go, ha, the butt farts. But my secondary channel is really comes from, after being on YouTube for such a long time, I was like, oh, wait, I have all this, like, influence, and I'm doing nothing with it but making silly jokes. And I realized, like, after doing a couple videos, like, just talking about something casual, like, oh, this is my bullying experience. You know, I was getting comments, like, hearing your story made me feel way more, like, way less alienated about being bullied, and then I would open up about my weight issues or mental health issues, and that just had this effect of encouraging people to, you know, maybe, like, seek any help they might need or feel less isolated, and that was wonderful. But really quickly, before this continues, I want to address what you said, Stevie, about what the downsides of oversharing is. I know them quite well. In my experience, some of them it can create this very strange relationship with your audience, yes, but the biggest downside is when you overshare information that isn't just you. Like, I can overshare about my mental health, but if I start oversharing about relationships or, like, my sex life, that story is only 50% mine to share, and to share it implicates someone else in something they may not, well, one person, maybe sometimes two or three. I get around.
Or seven, remember Friday?
Oh, yeah, my God. You are bendy. Yeah.
Derailed that one, sorry.
No, that was the end. That's fine.
No, fantastic.